Let us now study about the topic of refraction of light. This topic you might have studied in your early classes also. So, for the fundamentals of refraction here we can write that when a light travels through a boundary of two transparent media, from one medium to another, the phenomena is called a refraction of light. When a light goes from one medium to another, this phenomena we call refraction of light, and there are some physical analysis related to refraction of light that we'll see later how it takes place. Here we can also write another important term associated with refraction of light, for which we can write in different media, speed of light is different and it is associated in terms of refractive index of medium. We just defined the refractive index of a medium. This is denoted by the term mu. This is a Greek letter, or sometimes it is also denoted by the symbol of a small letter n. This refractive index is defined as the ratio of the speed of light in free space to the speed of light in medium. We know that the speed of light in free space is given by 3 into 10 to the power 8 meters per second, denoted by c. And say if in a given medium a speed of light is v, then here we can see velocity of light, the speed of light in a given medium, we can write as the c by mu. And in this situation, in every medium, we'll see later why in every medium the speed of light is less compared to that of free space. It is because of non-resonating oscillations of the medium particles. So, as always, the speed of light in different medium is less than the speed of light. Here we can see the value of mu is always greater than or equals to 1. For mu is equals to 1, we use that the medium is for free space we are talking about. And here we can also write one important fact that if we compare two medium and we are given that V medium 1, a speed of light in one medium is less than a speed of light in medium 2, then we say medium 1 is considered as optically denser medium with respect to medium 2. The medium in which the speed of light is more, this medium 2 is also termed as optically rarer medium. So the medium in which the speed of light is less is considered as optically denser, and the medium in which the speed of light is more is considered as optically rarer. In continuation, we can also write down a note which is important to understand about the laws of refraction. That is, when a light travels from one medium to another, unless it incidents normally the path of light ray, the path of light can also change either toward normal or away from normal. The situation is like this. Say we are having a medium 1 and medium 2 and a light ray incident at the boundary, and say if this is a normal to boundary. It depends on various situation, like if medium 2 is optically denser than medium 1, then the light ray bend toward normal. Or we can say this is the angle which we define as angle of incidence. This is the angle which we define as angle of refraction. Here we define I as the incidence angle and R as a refraction angle. So if medium 2 is optically denser, the light ray will bend toward normal, and it's vice versa is also true. Like if a light ray incident at an angle I, if this is medium 1 and this is medium 2, and here we are taking medium 2 as optically rarer medium, then the light ray will bend in the direction away from normal. The value of refraction angle R will be greater than I, whereas in case when light is refracted into a denser medium, the refracting angle is less than the incidence angle. So this variation in direction is related to the refractive indices of the medium that we'll study under laws of refraction, according to which the refraction of light is governed.